praise to our God. Please all rise.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, You are no longer strangers and sojourners, but you are fellow citizens with the holy ones and members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the capstone. Through him the whole structure is held together and grows into a temple sacred to the Lord. In him you also are being built together into a dwelling place of God in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Their message goes out through all the earth.
Their message goes out through all the earth.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day pours out the word to day, and night to night imparts knowledge.
Their message goes out through all the earth.
Now the word of our discourse, whose voice is not heard, through all the earth their voice resounds, and to the ends of the world their message.
Their message goes out through all the earth.
Jesus spread out with that news throughout the world. And as it were, those doves are still flying. They're coming to us as well. We've heard that expression, the apostolic succession, and it usually refers to the direct lineage you can trace for each new bishop that is consecrated, that the bishop who created. Him in turn was consecrated by a bishop, and the line goes all the way back to the apostles, the apostolic succession. There's a connection, and of course, we're part of that too. We we succeed the apostles in living the Word of God, hearing God's call, and as best we can, sharing with others. We might consider ourselves then one of those of fluttering offspring of doves who continue to stir up the world with the good news that Christ has given us. Inspired by the apostles who continue to come into Christ's presence to be taught and to share in prayer, so that we, as yesterday, we in all days need to continue to pray and fast for peace in the Middle East and in Ukraine and other troubled places in the world. May God's grace and peace present. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for those who feel some special call from God to enter our faith, to seek baptism, a special calling from the Lord. How they use their talents and time. May they trust that the Spirit is guiding them. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear
us. We are conditions to that for Simon Bahati. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
you continue to call us. Give us the grace of generous response to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Holy, holy,
Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts and offerings, these holy and blessed sacrifices, which we offer you for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope and Blaise, our Bishop, and all those who hold in the truth and honor, the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, what they've offered for themselves and those who are here to them, for the redemption of their souls and the hope of health and well-being, while paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communing with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Be pleased, O God, we pray, bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, Jesus bread. And your eyes raised to heaven, to you, his Almighty Father, he gave you thanks. He said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. Sacrifice, spotless paper. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember, Lord, your servants who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who are sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Felicity, Pedro, Agatha, Lucy, Cecilia, Adrian, Hilary, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their communion. Now, Mary and our merits, in granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
But deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy we may be free from all sin and safe from all distress as we await in blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your disciples, my peace I give you, my peace is with you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
Are we going to receive it?
St. Simon and Jude, literally in the presence of the peace of Christ, so are we. So we gladly share.
Thank you.
us as his disciples. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul. Let us pray. having received the sacrament, O Lord, we humbly implore you in the Holy Spirit that what we do to honor the glorious passion of the Apostles Simon and Jude may keep us ever in your love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This afternoon in the school parking lot, we have our annual trunk and treat event, 2 to 4 o'clock. For young people, everybody, they can come, and parents have decorated backs of their trucks or their cars, so the young people can come and get a Halloween treat. There's also other foods and things that can be enjoyed as well. Trunk and treat this afternoon. The Lord be with you.
May
Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have been inspired by Simon and Jude to go forth to carry out their good news message and life. Yes. Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is the Gallery Hymnal, number 646. I heard the voice of Jesus say.